So we're going to shake legs up here again and strip it back. Please bring them back. Courtney McKeon and Drew Pruitt. He's just one of those guys that's just an all-around good fella, jack-of-all-trades kind of guy. But one thing he is really, really good at, he's really good in the kitchen. You know, he makes his own bread, makes his own beef jerky and all that fun kind of stuff. But one thing he is really, really good at, he's really good at pickling. And this one year, he decided to enter into all four categories of the pickling competition in the local county fair. And didn't he come away with first place in all four categories? that is an aha moment, because in a little village of about 600 people, I gotta tell you, there was a lot of mad little old ladies in there. So we figured the newly crowned Pickle King deserved his own tune. This is a tune called the Pickle King Poker.
Thank you. much, folks. I just want to take this opportunity to thank those of you that picked up our CD at the break. That kind of support really, really means a lot to us. We know you don't have to do that, and you did that because you wanted to. And thank you to Sandy and Dell for helping us out with that. So thank you very much for your support. Other than for obvious financial reasons, and that we love to share our music with people, you're actually doing Gordy quite a big favor, because in a touring band, you know, sometimes we only have so much in our budget for flights and baggage and things like that. So if we have to ship those CDs back home, Gordy has to be a carry-on. He said he'd like to come back and dance again for you sometime, so thank you for your support. This is number 10 on Pickin' and Clickin', called Hey Boy. Thank you.
A big hand for the flying fingers of Mr. Thomas Lake on the beach again. Here for us right now. This is a tune that's going to be on our latest album, Laugh, Dance, and Sing. That's going to be the launch on October 9th, as I said. And we've been doing an awful lot of traveling, and we couldn't get to do the thing that we love to do, which is play for you folks, without some very loving people and very understanding people waiting for us back home. And one thing I noticed that every time we travel internationally quite a bit, and one thing I noticed is that every time I get a little homesick on the road, I'd go to call home and it was always either too late to call or too early to call. Everybody's always sleeping. So I decided to write them a tune so that they know that we're still thinking of them over home. And it's a tune called Maritime Lullaby.
Like Gordon was saying, we've traveled a lot in the last little bit. And this song was written on a day off in Ireland. And the guys took that day off and went down to Dublin to visit some historical aspects.
Museum.
Mostly museum parts. Industry type things. I stayed home. I would have loved to have gone, but I had a lot in my mind. I had just bought my wedding suit at the Marks and Spencer's. And I thought it was nice. I had a lot on my mind, so I went on a walk to think about things, and I ended up writing this song on the Cavan Road, so we call this the Cavan Road. Here we go.
Actually, as Pete's tuned the guitar there, I can I'll tell you a story about these sideburns because I was actually the only kid in the first grade with long sideburns. I couldn't really grow them at that age, so what I decided to do was grow my hair really, really long right here and just gel it to my face. Yeah, it looked pretty cool. I was definitely that weird kid in the class. And if you ever wonder what happens to all the weird kids in the class, they grow up and start folk bands. Here's four prime examples. This is a song we wrote kind of in that 50s style, and it's called I'm Gonna Get Out Before I Get In.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Well, sad to say, but we're getting near the end of our program here for you this evening.
Stay for another hour.
can we, Gorgeous? Can we stay up late tonight? But thank you, folks, very much for coming and taking a chance on us once again. It really does mean the world to us to see this, you know, this hall and this town that we've never been to before, and it's almost full, you know? So thank you very, very much. And I know that Bob mentioned some people were having, maybe there was a barbecue or two going on, which, you know, we can't blame those folks, you know? We'll be in ice cubes by the time we get home, so take it while you can, right? But as Mark mentioned earlier, we've gone through a few different genres of music this evening, but one thing we haven't covered, and I think is essential to folk song, is the Irish drinking song. So we've already returned to the road.
Once again on the guitar, we have Mr. Peter Can.
other dudes on the soccer to stick around. What do you think? You folks must have no homes here. You guys have been just wonderful here tonight. We had such a great time. And one of the best things you can ever do for a band like us is to spread the word, because we would love to keep on coming back here. So if you go to, thank you. So if you go to facebook.com/rhythmboys, give us a thumbs up on there. And we're going to be doing another tour of Ontario in April 2016. So you can also watch for us on crazylegs.ca. One night off here with a good old time bluegrass number.